Give me a big Miami welcome for Mr. Austin St. John. Come on, music.
How y'all doing?
Sounds like the spaceship or something.
All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to line people up over here to ask questions and such. Mr. St. John,
what's
line
up?
Them all up. All right. How are you doing today? How are you finding Miami? You enjoying it?
Hot, as if you can't tell. Like, people, do you see the suntan?
Yeah.
I just tell people I was getting into character. It's just a little extra red, you know what I'm saying?
And then the way we lit the stage for this, it also helps.
Is it you feeling the red? I mean, it's yellow, but it's red, right? That's what I'm talking about.
All right, let me see. Our first question today.
Ay, 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 ay.
You know who that is, right? That's Mr. Richard Horvitz, Alpha 5. He's signing autographs right across from me and Big Bird, baby. You better step up and say hello, show some love. What's up?
Mr. St. John, who would you say was the greatest robot that was ever on Power Rangers?
Well, I can think of five of them. Alpha 5, Alpha 5, Alpha 5, Alpha 5, and Alpha 5.
Yay!
That's what I'm talking about.
I had one last question for you. That is, why didn't you just start out as the Megazord?
You gotta leave a secret for something, you know what I'm saying? Good to see you, Rich.
Good to see you, Jason. I said, good to see you, Jason.
That's all right. Everybody else calls me Jason.
That's all right. Why don't we throw another chair?
We'll see you over there, Rich.
Did you want to go up? It's his thing? All right.
See anyone? See my man, Rich Horvitz, all right? He's here for y'all.
Next question? Unless you're another cast member I don't know about.
No, but I'm a magician. The guy shove a Sharpie up my nose and pull it out of my mouth. How's it going, man?
Good, man. What's up?
I still can't believe my childhood is standing right here. But I do have a serious question, though. What was some of the moments of the show that really just made you cringe looking back at it now?
Which ones?
Tell me, because this is like...
Let's set this up a little bit better. You enjoy doing this show, I'm correct?
Oh, man, all of us, I can speak for all of us when I say we had so much fun.
Is it fair to say that the Power Rangers were both awesome and campy or goofy at the same time?
That's a nice way of putting it.
Yeah,
I think so.
All right.
We had great times. I mean, one of the moments that stands out, I think, the most for me, as far as... I begged the director to change the line. Please, dear baby Jesus, don't make me say this. 25 takes later, I still couldn't do it with a straight face. Somewhere, I think, in the first 5 or 10 episodes, and they're all a blur for me, so you gotta bear with me. I had to come run around this corner in an alley, and there's this dumpster, and I think the other Rangers were with me, and I had to come around a corner, and I'm only 18. So maturity level was like right here. And I had to come running around this corner in all seriousness and be like, "You're going down, clown." I begged him to change that line. I said, "Change it to anything. You know, I got to take you down. You're going down, man. Something I can put some attitude behind." But no, I had to say it, and I had to mean it.
Were you fighting an actual clown?
I think it was this clown thing that turned into a bigger clown, because they all do. Like, you kill it the first time, and... As smart and as cool as the Rangers were, we never figured out that we're never going to just kill it once. It's always going to come back bigger. You know what I'm saying? So we would have been better to take it down, lock it up, and just put it in jail and never fight the big version. But, you know, then we didn't have dinosaurs and all that stuff. So I hated that line with a passion. It gave me great physical pain, and now I laugh about it a lot. So anytime.
Hello. I just want to say, you're a huge inspiration of mine growing up. And I read recently that you spent like 8 years as an emergency paramedic, the last 8 years. Are there any stories from that time that you want to share or that you thought like really inspired you?
That's a good question. Probably for the last 15 years, I've been in emergency medicine. I kind of had to grow up a little bit, you know, for Power Rangers.
Excuse me, is that also a red and white uniform?
No.
Oh, okay.
But I'm sure if my command had figured it out before they hired me, they might have done that to me. I'm sure.
So you got the blue shirt then, so it's all okay.
Yeah, it was blue or camouflage, depending on where I was. In answer to your question, we put a lot of stuff out about leadership and about how to live your life. And it didn't just impact all of you. It hit me pretty hard, too. I was 17 years old. I dropped out of high school. I got this job being a superhero and a legend and having to talk about being a leader for other children. And I hate hypocrisy, so it was something I had to figure out. When I left the show, I ended up working my way back through school, got my GED, finished up my bachelor's degree. Later on, I nailed down a degree in emergency medicine, became nationally certified as a National Registry paramedic, worked almost 12 years on the street in ambulances, firehouses, working or volunteering as a paramedic. And then I got my tactical medical operator, and the last 4 years have been almost exclusive work in the Middle East. I just got back April 1 of this year from the Middle East working as a medic overseas. So that's not for me, man. Those claps, that love right there, you need to hand that out to the boys in uniform. They're the ones that deserve that love.
Very cool.
Hi.
What's up, man?
Not much. First of all, big fan, obviously. Two quick questions. First of all, red or gold?
I love them both for two different reasons entirely. The red was kind of near and dear to my heart. It's an icon, as I've come to understand, is an iconic figure. I was the first red in America, anyway. In the English-speaking world, how about that? I was the first red, and that was huge. I had no idea what sort of impact I was having at the time. So I love it for that reason. It was my first. It started me on a road of travel. I never knew where it was going to end. And I'm still on that road here with you, even after years as a medic or in the Middle East. And so I love it for that reason. It got me started. But Gold Ranger was a badass. So I loved the Gold Ranger. He was just wicked. Cool suit too. I mean, come on. It's all about how many times can I change wardrobe, you know? It's like, bam.
All right, and the second one is who would win in a fight, Gold Zeo Ranger or White Mighty Morphin?
You know, I don't think either one of us would want to win. We're on the same team, man.
If you guys had to fight like Evil Green Ranger, Evil White Ranger, something like that.
Hello, Austin, again. Big
What's
fan.
Up? Of course. You changed again.
Yeah.
Oh, you got on my shirt now.
Yes.
All right,
yes.
Cool.
Good, awesome shirt. Will you, like, ever return to, like, you know, the Power Rangers in a way? Like, if Saban called you up and maybe gave you a better pay, would you do it?
Absolutely.
Awesome. Also, other question. Would you, if they called you for the new Mighty Morphin movie reboot, would you try to show up for that?
I think so.
Cool, cool, cool. That's all I need to say.
Yeah, my idea is that there's a whole new team that are the kids of the original Rangers. Like, they just came out with that show, Girl Meets World.
That would be cool.
Right? It'd be like
all right,
Morphin
all right.
Rangers 2.0.
Yeah, wow. I guess I could see that happening. It just makes me feel old. I'm not going to lie, but, you know.
But then you'd get to be the mentor.
As long as I'm not granddad Ranger.
No,
you know?
No. You'd have a son or daughter who's the new leader, and you'd have to teach them how to lead.
Yeah, well, my boy already calls me Daddy Ranger, so I guess, you know. Come on, Junior. Let's go. See them? Time to kick their asses, all right? Let's go take care of that. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, Austin.
Hey, buddy.
I know you saw me at the booth and everything. I shook your hand and everything. But
right.
You were like a big inspiration growing up when I was watching you on the show. And it was kind of a bit sad when you left the show. You, Zach, and Trini. It was a little bit hard for me to kind of get into what the other Rangers that replaced you. And my other question is, who would win in a battle? I know you said you'd be on the same team, but who would win, red or green?
I'm not asking his question. It's asked and answered, as the lawyers say.
Well, I think who won was already shown. I'm just saying the series gave out its own answers.
Well, there you go. And a real fan would know that.
Oh, all right. Much love, baby. Much love. And you're the man.
Hey, Austin. I heard that you started doing Power Rangers on a dare. Is that true? And if so, what is that story?
That's part of the truth. My volume is going up and down, or is that me? Okay. I had a $20 bet. And my mom had always kind of supported me, because I had told her I was interested in things, but I'd never really actively pursued acting. You know, I think I took some commercial classes and stuff for doing commercials at one point. But in addition to my mom, who, when this audition came out, because it came out in the newspaper, it was open to everybody in the LA area. It's what they call a cattle call, meaning everybody's welcome. And thousands of people showed up. It was ridiculous. But a friend of mine bet me $20 I wouldn't be wasting my time if I went for this audition. And I was like, hell, well, I'll go. I'm not going to get the part. There's thousands of people going. And $20 is sandwich money for a week. You know, I came up from a military family. I'm not rich. And, you know, household of public servants, there's a lot of feel good, but not a lot of money. And so I took the bet, lost, and world famous later, you know, with a show that none of us ever dreamt would turn into what it did. So, you know, my mom pushed me, supported me, and my dad was pissed because I dropped out of high school, and I lost $20. Damn it.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, man.
Hey, Austin, you know, you coming from a military family and dropping out of high school, going, becoming a famous actor, you know, you ended up being a civilian contractor out there helping our boys, yeah. How's that make you feel, like, inside knowing, hey, I'm a world famous actor, but I can be out there, boots on the ground, helping my boys out?
I take a lot of pride in spending as much time as possible training to be an excellent medic. I take a lot of pride in working hard to be there for anybody that needs me, whether they're in uniform or the guy right here on the floor. So I take pride in that, and not in a bad sort of way, but in a I think I'm doing the right thing sort of way. And I think even when I was younger, it was one of the things I put out there. You got to believe in yourself. You got to be your own keeper. And you know, part of something else that I'm working up, I've got a whole thing I'm getting ready to put together that's going to revolve around something called The Legend Lives in You. And I truly believe that, whether it's me or any of you. I feel good. I'm proud. I'm not a great man. I've made too many mistakes to ever make any sort of BS claims. I'm not going to tell people here I'm the greatest hero on the planet and that I deserve to be standing here. What I'm going to tell you is that I'm human. I make mistakes, and I spend every day trying to earn your respect, and I do it by trying to set the right example. So it makes me feel good, and I'm proud to have the opportunity to be here for folks like you and folks that wear the uniform overseas. So it makes me feel good, man.
Hey, coming from a United States Marine, much appreciated. I respect
Hoorah! That. My brother and my father, both Marines, man.
Hey, Austin. I'm trying not to fangirl here, but you're awesome. This is my first con, so I'm just like, Power Rangers, Jason. All right, so, okay, so I know that, like, with musicians, there's, like, the first time they hear their song on the radio or, like, when they kind of realize, oh, they might be, you know, they might have some semblance of success. What do you have, like, a specific moment when you realize that, oh, this power, like, Power Rangers, this is actually going to be big? Like, my life is never going to be the same again.
Yeah, my boy, sorry about that, blew you out. My boy Walt and I, we get asked that question a lot. And for those of you who don't know, Walter Jones, Karen Ashley, David Yost, they're all here with me. A bunch of the other Rangers down here. There's a Ranger everywhere. So take a left turn, take a right turn, you're going to find one of us. But I think there are a couple moments. One of them is Universal Studios. That was just, there was no way to miss the fact that things were just ridiculous. Ridiculous. Like 100,000 people in the park. We broke attendance records. We shut down the 101 freeway. I mean, it was ridiculous. It was crazy. stands out there on Universals that were selling Power Rangers stuff got overrun. Like, people got angry. What do you mean you're sold out? I'm here with my four-year-old. I'm gonna need a toy right now, boy. You know, calm down now. You're supposed to be setting the example too for your little boy. Stop beating up the poor man selling stuff. You know, so we saw some wild stuff like that, and that was just mind-blowing for us. But I remember the first time when the producer, Jonathan Zecora, we were shooting late. It was late night. I think Walt was there with me. We're sitting in our chairs. And I had the top half of my Red Ranger uniform tied around my waist. We'd been working all damn day. We were sweating like crazy. We were tired. And I'm sitting there reading, and Jonathan comes down, and he speaks with this very heavy, you know, Jewish accent. And for those of you who are Jewish, I'm probably terrible at this accent, but I'm trying. And he comes down, he says, hey, you know, I need to tell you that your show has become number one in the world, number one children's television series everywhere. And I remember Walt and I were sitting there, I kind of looked at him, he looked at me, and I'm sitting there thinking to myself, self? What does that even mean? Like, wow, cool. I'm really tired. And Walt kind of looked at me, we looked at each other, and we're like, that sounds cool. But we had been shooting so much back to back, like endless episodes with very little break, 18-hour days, almost the entire first year. Most TV series use one episode a week. We were shooting two or three a week sometimes, so we were insane. So we didn't have really time to get out and like have a social life. So even though that's when I was first told, it was a long time before Walt and I and probably the other guys, before we could really get out in the world and see that there was this fandom that was just on fire, going bananas. So that's the first time I heard about it. I mean, Universal Studios is probably the first time I was just run over by it. Good question.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, man.
I think this is pretty awesome. I'm a majority of people here, but I spent my childhood obsessed over Power Rangers. I just wanted to know, how weird was it, since you were so young, seeing your actual face on toys, yourself in video games, and have you played yourself in the video game for Power Rangers?
You know, you have to word that very carefully.
Michael, what's up? He asked if you played yourself. There was no other words in that sentence.
Like I said, you have to word that very carefully. I have not played the video game. I've seen a few of them out there. Maybe I would do that one day, like if I could actually find one. As far as my toys go, I remember the first time I held myself in my hand. Probably could have worded that better too, huh? Anyway, that was a little bit of a mind trip for me. I think maybe I was 18, if that. And I'm like, hey, that's me. It looks nothing like me. Like, come on, man. I know you have pictures of me. Like, reels and reels and reels of film, and this is what I look like? But that was kind of a just, I'm not gonna lie, I had a moment. I was like, this is cool. So that it was cool, but I think everybody had more toys of me than I did. We were working so much, we never got, like, Bandai never came to us and said, hey, man, you guys rock. Here's a whole collection of you and your own business as Power Rangers. It was more like, we're selling toys. Now you must go back to work so we can sell more toys. And so that's kind of how that went down. But I tell you what, I'd love to check it out. I've seen some of you guys have come up with toys that have got to be 20 plus years old, like still in the box. That's crazy. Like, where do you guys, that's awesome. So.
Never been opened is a point of pride.
Yeah. I'm like, that's control. Because when I was six, I would have been like, shh, toys everywhere.
Last time you showed up on Power Rangers was during the Forever Red episode. I forgot what series it was part of, but how did it feel to be with all those other Red Rangers now that you've had time to mature and know that you were the first and there's so many that had come after you? How was that for you?
It was check. It was pretty cool, man. I had really left Hollywood. I hadn't really looked back on it. So I remember when I got approached and everybody was telling me, hey, you know, you should come back. You should do this Forever Red episode. All the other Red Rangers are going to be there. I was like, okay, you know, 2, 3, what? Something like that. And they're like, no, 11. I was like, what? I'm getting old. Damn it. And but I came back and, you know, I got to meet all the other guys. And it was just, it was really cool. It was unlike any of the other episodes I'd ever shot. We had a great time. My part of the shooting was almost exclusively done in, I think, just a couple days, because I was really just at the aircraft hangar. That was it. You know, pulled up on a Harley, showed up, we did some handshaking, we shot everything in about a day, maybe two. And then all the crazy footage that's all filmed everywhere else happened everywhere else. And it was just really cool to sit down and meet a lot of the other guys. And, you know, all good people, all really chill. And it was just cool to hang out with them all, you know what I mean?
Hey, can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, I can.
All right, awesome. I just want to clarify a story that I read online. Back when Zero was airing and your episode just aired, Fox Kids had a radio station, I think. I was too young to remember that.
Yeah.
Apparently you were on it and Tom Hanks was also in that episode too. I was just wondering if that was true or someone was just lying on Ranger Board. Did you ever like film a radio show with Tom Hanks for Fox Kids?
Well, I filmed a lot of radio shows. Okay. I don't remember ever having Tom Hanks sit across like on a microphone from me, but that doesn't mean, because commonly what happens in these radio interviews is they'll have you call in, you'll do the radio interview, and then they'll piece it together with other actors who've also called in and done it.
Okay.
So it's entirely conceivable that they may have piece parted Tom and myself and three other guys into like the same hour time interview and then pumped it up. But I've never sat across from Tom Hanks to do an interview.
Cool. All right. Thank you so much. I got one more question. On your Facebook, you posted a photo of yourself at the Oscars, like back in '96.
I was in a tux. I was on my way. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I was just wondering, is there a story behind that, besides of you getting invited to the Oscars, or how'd that happen?
No. It was just I had some friends at the time who were big in the celebrity world, and I had that tux made at the time, specifically for it. I don't even know who shot the photo, like. There are a lot of photos out there of me that I think were taken by paparazzi that I never even knew existed until I came back and got into this. And that photo and that tux was never taken by me or my people, and it's the only one I ever have of me in it. So when I found it, I was like, wow, I know what that was. But no, man, we just went and we chilled at the Oscars. We had a good time at the after party. And, you know, pretty much the way I am. I'm just chill and hang out.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, man.
Hey, Austin.
What's up?
Not much, man. Just to clarify, that episode that you were talking about, You're Going Down, Clown?
Yeah.
That's the one when you guys went after the Pinoctopus.
Of course it was.
Yeah. In the first season on disc, I believe it was Volume 1. I got all the series on DVD, so I've been catching up.
The Pinoctopus. Is that what it was?
Pinoctopus.
So I didn't even have to say the word clown.
No.
Damn it.
All right, I'll...
Thanks for straightening that out.
You're going down, puss.
Okay, now I understand why I said clown. All right, I got it.
Yeah, he was dressed as a clown.
I was?
No, the Pinoctopus.
See? All right, it's all coming back to me now. I got it.
That's why you said you're going down, clown.
I still hate that line, but thank you.
All right, I want to ask... Filming the show, who was your favorite evil villain to fight against?
Well, I fought Goldar all the damn time.
That's true.
So, I love Goldar. But I think Rita's kind of where my heart is because that's where it started. But Zed was, he was just fun. Like, and then later as I was leaving, Zed and Rita became an item and they had this whole dysfunctional marriage thing. And then kind of got warped. I was glad I missed that part, but probably Goldar. I spent a lot of time in the green arena with Goldar, so yeah. It was good times.
Thank you.
Yeah, man.
Out of all the incarnations or seasons or whatever you want to call it of Power Rangers that you weren't on, which one would you like to been on the most?
Is there another team you would have been on, would like to have been on?
Yeah, well, I'm trying to think. You know, I haven't really seen any of the other series. Like I said, when I left Hollywood, man, I rolled out. I was changing careers. I was moving on. and I'm just now kind of coming back to it for the first time in 20 years. I've heard some really cool stuff about Galaxy. I've heard some cool stuff about SPD.
Yeah.
I'd have to look at it. I'm not even sure. Like, I'd really have to sit down and watch it more. And really, my limited knowledge now is based on some of the following Rangers that I've met since I've been back on the circuit. And they're all really cool. And that's really what's more important to me is, can I hang out and chill with people? And I don't know. I think I'd have to sit down and look and see how they were written. People have told me so many things about all the changes that took place. I really have no idea. Like, my show was campy, as he puts it. I don't know how the other shows were, but so I'm kind of curious to see. I'd have to check it out and give it a try, you know what I mean?
First of all, happy 4th of July.
Happy 4th of July. Happy Independence Day.
Okay, so when you first started your show, were you like one of those nervous people? Like, oh, can I do this? Or were you like, I can do this?
Would you say that one more time?
I can do this.
I love that. Can we can that and sell it? How old are you?
I'm going to be 11 in September.
Now, how many of you at 11 years old would have had the courage to get up and say that to your superhero? That's pretty awesome. Let's get a round of applause. You go, girl. Good for you. I was 17. Just a little bit older than 11, at least physically, maybe not mentally. And I think the initial auditions, I was nervous, but I was confident. And there's a difference between confidence and arrogance. And I think I felt like I knew I was capable of it, but I wasn't sure if I was gonna slip and bust my butt or say something stupid by accident, you know what I mean? So I think I was pretty confident. But I definitely had butterflies at moments, like, oh, man, here we go. All right, get your head straight. Check. Remember your lines. Not check. Review the lines, you know, things like that. So there were moments of nervousness, but I think I was pretty confident that I was capable of doing whatever I needed to do to get the job done. And if there was something I didn't know, I was confident enough to know that I was going to learn how to do it so I could get it done. That's a really good question.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm in love.
Hey, Austin.
What's
how
up?
How are you?
Good, man.
Quick question for you. How many kids do you have and how old are they?
I have 2 children. There's 4 and 16/17 months.
Okay. As for the 4-year-old, has he expressed any interest in wanting to act? And if so, if they did want to act in the future, would you support them?
He hasn't expressed anything further than I'm going to kick butt, and one moment I'm Spider-Man, the next moment I'm Captain Hook, the next moment I'm Daddy Ranger, the next moment I'm Batman, the next moment I'm Flash. I have more wardrobe changes with my child than I did in Hollywood. And it's like, really, whew, it's a lot of costume changes. So he's in that whole 4-year-old world of imagination, you know? Monsters and heroes are very real to him at this age, and I love watching it. It's an awesome part of being a dad.
Does he want to know where you have the Zord parked?
He's asked where the costume is.
Yeah.
And he's been told that is in a top secret location and only used when really needed. But he has worn the helmet, and he kind of dug that. In fact, I think I put a picture up on Facebook. He wasn't wearing my suit, but he was wearing my helmet, and it got like 25,000 hits. It was good times. As far as if you wanted to be an actor in the future goes, I think I might try to lead him in a more secure career direction, is one way to put it. 500,000 actors in Hollywood, and maybe 10,000 are actually working. But if that was truly something that he loved doing and wanted to go after it, absolutely. That's my job as a daddy. One of them, anyway.
One last question. At any point, was there any chance for you to co-star on the VR Troopers?
I was already locked into Power Rangers. VR Troopers actually shot next door to us, but I didn't even know it existed for like a month or two. I saw stuff going in and out, knew they were filming something there. And I was so busy doing my own stuff already, it just never even crossed my page. I was a busy guy.
All right, thank you.
Anytime.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, so knowing that the original Power Rangers show got so watered down compared to Zoo Ranger, right? Especially things like Green's storyline and such. How in the world did Lord Zedd get through in the state he did for American audiences?
He's kind of
terrifying.
He's a bit terrifying, and how in the world he did this, I'm not quite sure. Where are you from, buddy?
Southern England.
Southern England. Very cool. I always like the English accent. You're not Cockney, though, because I can actually understand what you're saying. I really don't know. He was kind of jacked and ripped and red and no face, and he was kind of evil looking. He was creepy. I remember when he came on, I was like, oh, we got a real bad guy. I was kind of excited by that. I don't know. I guess maybe everybody had a hard time with the bad Rita Repulsa lip sync. I mean, everybody loved the voice, and she was a memorable character, but I think they were looking for something new, and I think they were looking for something they didn't have to tie a face to. Like Zedd, the helmet could be on any man, and the second whoever was in Zedd's face said, I'm done being Zedd, it didn't matter because they put it on the next guy. But America loved him. The world loved him. He was a huge hit as a bad guy. So I don't know how he made it through, but people loved him.
Okay, thank you.
Anytime.
What's up, Austin? I have two questions. The first one, do you still talk to, I can't remember his real name, but Tommy?
I haven't talked to him in some time. I'm sure that we're going to run into each other out here on the circuit somewhere. And we'll chat, but I haven't seen him in a long time. In fact, the first guy that I really have reconnected with in a long time is Walter Jones, and now Dave and Karen. And I've seen them back out on the circuit too, because I just was out of Hollywood, you know? I moved on to other things. But I'm positive we'll see each other at some point, and I'm sure we'll get the opportunity to speak.
And the second question is, may their spirits rest in peace, but did you go to Trini or Sauron's funeral?
I didn't know about what had happened until too long after the fact to attend it. Okay. I wish I had.
Thank you.
So, Austin, I got to admit to you, this is a great honor getting a chance to talk to you, and I'm sure everyone here like appreciates the fact that you traveled all the way from the Middle East just to come out here and just to talk to us. So I want to say thank you.
My pleasure.
So, and I'm thinking the biggest question everybody had was, what took you so long to come back? I know you were out in the Middle East, doing your thing, being a hero. But, I mean, honestly, like I think it was, 2007? Your last appearance was at Morphicon. And we haven't seen, and it's now 2014. So, I mean, we all missed you.
I appreciate that. I think initially I had no idea people were missing me. Other than my family, of course.
Greatly.
I'm kind of relearning this. I just didn't expect there was so many people still here after all this time. And you can thank Walter Jones. He actually, I usually would chat with him maybe once a year, twice a year, we'd catch up. And I was in Kuwait on the Iraqi border, and I was talking to him on the phone, and I was like, hey man, I'm done. I need a breather from medicine and the Middle East, and you know, I'm coming home. And he's like, well, hey, I'm on the con circuit. I'm meeting all these fans. He's like, dude, they grew up. And, you know, I mean, like, okay, sure. But to hear how they grew up and hear how we impacted their lives as children has been one of the most amazing experiences of my entire return to the circuit. I've heard some heart-wrenching and heartwarming stories about kids, boys, girls, families that were going through some times that blow my mind. And, you know, and then to have them look me in the eye and dead serious tell me that I or my teammates were the reasons that they could get through it every day, it's just mind-blowing. To any man who knows he makes mistakes, it's mind-blowing to hear that I had that impact on people. And so what took me so long was, hey, I didn't know you guys were still here. I couldn't fathom why anybody would still be there maybe waiting on me. It just didn't cross my mind, you know. I didn't think of me as that special a guy. There's been 25 of me by now, right? So I think the other side of it is once I heard about it, I kind of had to go on my own life journey, man. I'm my own keeper. I had to grow up. I had to make some good decisions, some bad decisions, and I had to learn how to be a better man. And that was just kind of my path, same one that each of you are on. And that's what I was doing. And I think I'm still working on being a better man, but I'm here with you now, and you guys are going to teach me different lessons, just like maybe I taught you growing up. So it's a great time, a great place to be here, and I'm just happy to be back with you all, you know?
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Anytime.
What's up, buddy?
What's up, man?
Oh, sorry I'm not red. Hey, man. I hope you don't hate me.
Green's looking good. Do you do, man. That's your gig.
I appreciate it. Thank you. We're all happy that you're here. You know, we missed the Red Ranger, and it's a pleasure to be talking to you, man. You know, I grew up watching you, and of course, all of Power Rangers, Mighty Morphin and whatnot, but only until recently did I, probably within the last year, watch from start to finish the original Zeo Ranger, where all your source material came from, and it's just completely night and day, and I had no idea. And my question is, have you ever actually sat down and watched, legitimately, the Zeo Ranger series?
No, but my son has got it memorized.
Yeah?
Yeah, I find myself exceptionally busy, and I can't even tell you all the things I have coming into the works for the fans. And I find my head spinning trying to keep up with getting everything done and moving, and I have an exceptional group of people working with me in so many different aspects of it. If I have a moment to sit down and watch TV, usually it's 9, 10 o'clock at night, and I'm sitting down on the couch with the wife, and we're watching Property Brothers or, you know, whatever happens to pop up, and I'm just sitting there like drool coming out of my face, like spent. But I actually have told several people that I need to sit down and kind of just rewatch everything. And I look forward to doing it. I just haven't had that much time yet.
Nice, man. It's not going anywhere. It's all on YouTube. It's easy to find. Don't worry.
Absolutely.
And we got me, myself, we got a White Ranger, we got a Red Ranger, we got a Gold Ranger. We're all waiting for you. Take a nice, awesome photo op, man.
Well, bring your butts up here. Let's do it. Come on. Right now.
Faster the better. Stairs are on the far side.
There you go, guys. So we got green, red, gold, and white. I see a whole lot of bad coming up the stairs.
That's right.
I don't know. We're at a sci-fi convention. All I see is there's no girl in their group.
Hey, man. Pleasure.
No comment.
Hey, man. Good to meet you, bud.
Thanks.
Good to meet you, brother. What's up, man?
What's up, man?
Who's shooting?
Where's the camera?
He's right here. He's getting set.
Silly question. There's a million cameras. Which camera are we using? That guy.
All right.
Okay. Now, when I did it, wasn't it faster than this?
Yeah.
It's like, bam! Come on, we're not Hollywood. I had to give him a hard time. I'm just saying. A lot of memories here.
All right, man. Do one on
that side. One step forward. Good. Two rangers on either side of
Austin. All right, what are we going to do, man? We want to strike a pose or Vogue? What do we...
All right, everybody got it? There we go. A round of applause. That was really cool of you, Austin. Thank you.
You guys are awesome.
You just made four guys' dreams come true. Okay, remember to remove your helmets before trying the stairs.
Try fighting in your helmets. Pretty sure we had to use some Star Wars force on that one. I don't know how we survived.
Hi,
Austin.
Well, hello, darling.
How are you?
I'm good.
Cool. My question is, when did you decide to enlist in the military?
I was not in the military.
Oh.
I was a contractor. I did some work with Department of Defense, and I was attached to military bases throughout the country of Kuwait, where I worked with all branches of the U.S. military. But I also took care of contractors. I took care of everybody on military installations, as did many other medics and captains and chiefs and good people. It was a big team.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Hi again.
I remember you.
First of all, my brother, you're like his god. He couldn't be here, but like he adores you, and I'm still watching like your old episodes with him.
That's very cool.
The second thing is, do you think we'll get a female ranger, and how would you feel about that?
Bring it on. Why not?
Yeah.
You should see my wife when she gets mad. Come on, man. Woo. Yeah, that'd be great. I don't know what color they make. I mean, we need the first female red ranger.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Red.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, that's what you're talking about. There's a female leader?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but she'd have to be red, because that's that's where it sits.
That's where it sits.
Yeah.
Because I thought you were asking, because we do have the actresses come out. And if you check out Supercon Wrestling, you might have a Power Ranger surprise. You might want to check out that, the girls of Power Supercon Wrestling.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello, Austin. It is an honor to meet you. My brothers, my sister, and I, we every day after school, we come and watch the Power Rangers. Like, we watched the whole entire season until you left the Red Ranger uniform. And every time I've seen you practice martial arts, and I've seen you work out a lot, and you had this grudge against the Green Ranger, and that we're like, wow, I really admire your training. I mean, I really wanted to be like you, and my brother's like, no, I want to be the Red Ranger. My question is that, have you been in, like, in other in TV, like, movies, like, other, like, in 2014 movies or anything like that?
I did a couple of bit parts in the late 90s in some movies. I think upcoming, I have two features that are in the works. I really can't disclose particulars at this time. I also have some TV work coming up that, again, I can't disclose the information on. Those of you that are on Facebook, if you follow my Facebook page, I will tell you this. In the next 90 to 120 days, you can expect some information on exactly what I just talked about, and probably in far more detail than I can tell you right now.
And what is it they put into Facebook to find you, your page? Facebook.com/?
It's just Austin St. John. And you'll see it. It's got the blue medic symbol with the red helmet and the gold icons and stuff. And it's got my ugly mug up there. And I know there's a million Austin St. Johns that all have all that. But you'll know it when you see it. It's got all the current pictures. It's going to have stuff from here. I think right now we've been on for about 4 months since I've joined this page. I think we're in 4 months getting ready to crack about 70,000 people. And I'm hoping in the next year we're going to, year, 2 years, crack a million. So
I believe you will.
You'll know it when you see it.
Thank you so much. This is really an honor. I'm truly a fan of yours, Mr. Singh.
Thank you, brother.
First of all, Austin, I want to welcome you to Miami.
Thank you.
And if you need a jet ski or boat, bro, I got a boat out there, man. Just bring your helmet. Me and you will ride out, man.
A boat? Is that what you said?
Yeah, I got a boat, bro. I saw you yesterday on posting pictures on Jesky, bro, and I was here, and you were out there, and I'm normally out there.
Okay, all right.
Hey, bro, can I take a picture of you, man, or just chill?
Well, I tell you what, I'm going to be back over there. I don't want to...
Now is a really good time to plug your booth number. Do you remember what it is?
No.
No, all right. I'll have somebody look it up and bring it to
you. I'm right over there.
All right.
Yeah.
These by Pillar 46. Have you guys figured out how to navigate that way? You look up at the top of the columns. There we go. So 46 is way back there. All right.
Hi, Austin.
Well, hello.
I wanted to ask you, how did it feel to kind of
one, come back for the Turbo movie for Power Rangers Turbo, and two, kind of have like a few moments of playing a quote-unquote villain for that little segment in the movie you were in?
I loved being a bad guy. Loved it. I want to be a bad guy some more. I had a great time, and I had a great time. I can't. Bad guys have all the fun. Like, I had a lot of fun being a good guy, but I had so much more fun being a bad guy, and I want to do some more. I'm just saying. So either that, or I want to be like a good guy that's struggling with his demons or something. You know what I mean? So I had a blast coming back, and there was some discussion with Shuki Levy about the movie and the script, and I was like, hey, man, can I be a bad guy? He was like, well, you know, maybe this is a possibility. Maybe we should discuss this, you know? And next thing I know, I'm a bad guy. I loved it.
All right, I have a second question for you. Since, like, the early footage of, like, Mighty Morphin Power Rangers is kind of, like, spliced between what you guys were doing and also what the original show was, did you guys, like, watch some of the old things? Like, okay, this is what the Red Ranger does from Japan, so I have to do a lot of these things, too. And when did you guys kind of stop using those clips to using your own?
Well, they brought in the Japanese footage for the first, I think it was about 40 episodes, which was all already shot in Japan, all the helmeted stuff. So we rarely even got to wear the costumes at that point, except for occasionally in the command center where we'd pop off the helmets, we'd have a conversation, and then, you know, it's morphin' time, and then it's back to the Japanese footage. Once they ran out of that footage, then they started shooting. We started, those of us who love to do our own stunts, myself, Walt loved doing his out of the original five, the original team. They both loved doing their stunts. We would jump on any chance we got. And then I think a little bit later, we got the shooting schedule was so crazy that even if we could do the stunts, sometimes we had to be over here on camera unit A instead of camera unit B or C, which were doing stunts. So I was like, damn it, you know, I want to do that flip in that fight scene, but the director tells me I got to be right here with my face. So I didn't really even, I've never seen a Japanese episode. I'd like to. But what I have seen is what you guys have seen.
Okay. And one last little question. How much do you laugh when you see, like, the online things about saying you've been a quote-unquote porn star?
How to keep this answer politically correct.
Well, I just asked, how much do you laugh? It's like, pop, you only know what I was really doing.
You know, all right, well, I got to let it out. Look, man, if there are people out there that are dumb enough to believe that crap, then I hope they have a good time with it. I laugh a lot. I mean, it's so stupid, it's painful. It's funny stuff.
Thank you.
You're welcome, darling. So I think we got to crunch this up. I'm getting the high sign for move faster.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
So we saw you in Spanish back home, and it's like just bringing back memories. And when we saw who was coming into this is our first convention also, so I'm having the Power Rangers here and the original Power Rangers, it's like, it's so real and it's fun, and I just wanted to tell you that. Because it's like, we're like 20 years old, 20 years ago.
Yeah, so. Yeah. So you got to see, me speak in Spanish.
Yes.
O sea, hola, ¿cómo está? ¿Qué tiempo es ahora? Ahora es morphing time. So.
Something like that, right, yes.
Necesito mucho más practicar con mi español. Es de mucho gusto.
No, but that was really good.
Gracias.
De nada, nice to meet you. And
you too.
I'll take a picture with you over there.
I'll probably be there to take that picture.
All right, good. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
It's table 6 over underneath column 46.
Make it short and sweet. What was one of the best perks of being in the Power Rangers, and what was the not so cool consequences of being in the Power Rangers?
I got kind of a funny one. As far as the best parts, I love looking up at the children. I mean, it just kind of struck me in my heart every time I look at a little boy, a little girl, and they're looking at me like I would have looked at Superman when I was 5. So that I remember that to this day. That's always been a huge impact, and I never stopped loving that look. It was just, It's just breathtaking for me. As far as some of this not so cool moments, I sat down at a Wendy's, man. I was sitting at a Wendy's, I ordered a chicken salad, I was gonna eat my salad, have my drink, and I was maybe 2 miles from where we shot in Valencia, and this busload of girls comes in. I mean, like, Greyhound bus of girls. I think they were going to Six Flags or something up in the area. And I was like, okay, cool, let me go over in the corner and sit down facing the wall. And so I sat down, and I realized when I got there that I forgot my dressing. So I turn around, and they're all over, they have, like, taken over the whole floor of Wendy's. The invasion was well underway. And I'm like, I have to navigate through the jungle, get up there, get some ranch dressing, and make it back without being discovered. I failed the mission miserably. And made it back to my table, and there was all kinds of craziness because the show was hot at the time. And finally, things calmed down. I was like, I gotta eat and go back to work. And I turn around to eat my salad and have my drink. And somebody, like, you know how when you're gonna do something, you put your fork in the lettuce and you just stab it there and it stands up for a minute? Somebody stole my damn fork and my straw. Now there comes a moment in time where I have to say to myself, self, this is a little bit ridiculous. Like, it had beans on it. It had been in my mouth. What are you gonna do with that? What did your mama teach you? You know what I'm just saying? Like, we gotta talk about this. So that was kind of one of the most ridiculous moments that I still laugh about to this day.
Hi, Austin.
Hello, ma'am.
So anyway, on YouTube, I saw a promo of what was gonna originally be the first Power Rangers episode with you in a bowling alley.
Yes.
What the heck was that? Because I think I got cancer from watching that.
Well, you should stop watching that.
It was horrible. What was that?
Whose
idea was that?
The first director. That was the original uncut pilot.
Dude, you would have failed.
Let's flip that question a little bit.
Sure.
How did you get from a first director and a first attempt at a pilot to the show most of these folks fell in love with?
Well, the original pilot was shot, the fight scenes were much more epic.
We guests from Arrow and Spartacus have returned for lunch and will be signing autographs for the next 30 to 40 minutes before their panel.
All right, you heard it.
On the main stage.
You're still hearing it.
At 4:30.
And we're done, okay. The original episode was shot with a lot of heavy fights, and we were allowed to punch people in the head, kick people in the head, and I mean, I laid out some full-blown kicks. Bulk, who was my first enemy, even in the original pilot, I kicked him so many times in the head, they actually cut away from my foot ever making contact with his face. They just show me throw the kick, and then you see him stumbling back. Even by the time that made it to 20th Century Fox for pickup for the season, they were like, oh, this is still way too violent. So they cut it all back, and then to this day, all you're gonna see on Power Rangers fight scenes are shots to the body. You never see a hand or a foot make contact with a head. And unless somebody cut something wrong, maybe in an episode somewhere. But that was kind of the premise between the first one. They're like, oh, it's way too violent. So they redid it, we reshot it. The Yellow Ranger had departed, and Twee came in, and so that's kind of the backstory to it anyway. And I always thought it was weird. Like, how are you gonna tell me this is violent? Do you ever watch Wile E. Coyote and Bugs Bunny? I mean, we're not dropping each other off a cliff. You know, help me out here. But, you know, they ruled and we changed. And thanks to you guys, you made it a global hit.
All right, Miami, let's give a big round of applause for Mr. Austin St. James. You can see more of him over at Table 6, which is over there underneath column 46, over there in the corner.
Thank you guys for coming to see me.